we're hanging out with fur seals.
You know they want to play.
They're all just staring at us.
And uncovering the dark history of these waters.
It can run down the fastest whales.
And that would throw a spear.
Yeah, that would penetrate the body of the whale.
I'm Alizé Carrère, an environmental anthropologist and National Geographic explorer. This is my friend Tom Ritchie, a naturalist who spent decades in the field. Together, we'll discover what it means to be a modern explorer. Today, we're going on an expedition to South Georgia, an island within the Antarctic climate. This remote shoreline is covered in hundreds of thousands of fur seals, king penguins, and elephant seals. But it wasn't always this way. Less than a century ago, these beaches were barren, without a seal in sight. Humans nearly destroyed this ecosystem, and the ruins of their handiwork still dot the landscape. Tom and I are kayaking through the graveyard of one of South Georgia's most prolific whaling stations, where thousands of slaughtered whales were processed.
There were temporary places set up, and they would just moor a ship and then bring the whales into the ships and process them that way. But, you know, when they did that, they were wasting the meat, the bones and everything, just
right,
taking the blubber off and then casting the carcasses out. So these shore-based stations were able to take advantage of the whole carcasses.
Over 175,000 whales were slaughtered on the island. But the devastation of wildlife by humans on South Georgia began before whalers arrived in search of whale oil and byproducts. Going back to the late 1700s, seal hunters were coming here to kill seals by the millions so they could harvest their pelts. Before hunters arrived, there were millions of fur seals and elephant seals on South Georgia. By the time they left, there were fewer than 400 seals on the island. Ships like these were lethal to the whales of the South Atlantic.
It could run down the fastest whales, blue whales, fin whales, and then with that gun on the bow.
Oh my God, yeah.
Yeah, it's a cannon.
And that would throw a spear.
Yeah, that would shoot a harpoon, and the head of the harpoon point, would penetrate the body of the whale, and it had a grenade in it, and it would blow up and kill the whale fairly quickly by exploding inside its body. This was a town. There were, I don't know, maybe 400 people here at one time.
This whaling station closed nearly a century ago, but nature finds a way to bounce back. Now the wreckage is occupied by fur seals, who've made it their playground.
Look at these young fur seals in this shipwreck.
You know, there are at least 50 of them in here.
Wow.
This is where mothers can leave off their pups while they go out to feed.
I love the transformation of time, how this was once a vessel to kill these creatures, and now here they are just completely populating it and recreationally.
Well, you know, look at this whole place. This was an area where initially, in the early 1800s, all of the fur seals were killed. Then all of the elephant seals were killed. Then almost all of the whales were killed. And now the place is in ruin. They ran out of things to kill. The fur seals have come back. The elephant seals are coming back. The whales are coming back very slowly. But, you know, this is now an oasis for all these creatures.
Nature is resilient, but it's still recovering from our mistakes. Lucky for us, the fur seals of South Georgia are an incredible success story. This is what can happen when nature is given a second chance.
So these are this year's pups. And you can see there's a little bit of size variation, but the ones that are grayish, blue-gray, they've already molted into their juvenile pelage. And they're the ones looking at us right now, not knowing what to do.
You know they want to play.
They're all just staring at us.
wondering what we are.
Well, we do look a little funny.
Looks like they're daring each other. There they come.
There they come.
South Georgia is now a protected area. That means these fur seal pups can just focus on being pups. Our tools are different, our technology is different, and the landscape is changing. Exploring means something very different from the past. But there will always be room to observe and protect the wonder of our world. And that's what makes a modern explorer.